Who's got a comment? Yes, over here.
I think today I've heard some very disheartening and dangerous statements. I think we have to be careful in what traumas happen to our family, not to let them affect our worldview, right? Because my brother-in-law was killed by the police, which I know, which was founded to help capture enslaved people or newly freed people. So we have to make sure we have all the facts on what's going on. Or to say that we don't still feel the effects of what happened 150 years ago, I don't know Patrice, but I know my great-grandmother was a slave, and I know that the reason I feel a sort of way when I get pulled over is because of what happened to the newly freed people. And I know that reparations is equal to accountability, which our country fails to do, right? Right now, we're talking about modern-day book burning by whitewashing history. We don't want to teach people that look like me what really happened to our ancestors. And I think that's equally dangerous. And I think that it's incumbent upon all of us to know what America came from, right? There's a reason we don't do the third stanza of the Star-Spangled Banner, because it references something we don't want to take accountability from, which where reparations starts that conversation. Maybe it's not a payment, maybe it's education, maybe it's taxes, but first on, it's owning our history, which we don't want to do.
Yeah. Okay, who else has a comment? Over here, uh-huh.
If it's about discrimination as well, where do other races fall into all this, such as the Hispanic community or the Asian community? Do they get, you know, monetary value as well? Or is it more focused on just, you know, one community?
So anytime we talk about Black Americans and reparations or what's happening today and how it connects to chattel slavery, everybody suddenly wants to talk about everything else. Let's talk about classism. And there is an intersection between classism and sexism. Mm-hmm. But we're not talking about that right now. Now you want to say, well, what about everybody else? This is what happened. This is why nothing has been done all this time, because we can't stay focused on one issue at a time. We're talking about something very specific that we want to address that has not been addressed, so we need to face that first. Once we do that, or while that's happening, we can be addressing other things too. But we can't keep gaslighting and being like, well, people who are poor, they're dealing with issues too. People who are from the Asian community are dealing with issues too. No one said that they weren't. But we're trying to deal with one issue and get solutions for that first, because it should have happened a long time ago and it still hasn't happened. So it's time to pay up.
I agree. It has to start somewhere.
We're not even starting.
Yeah. But it has keep getting to start distracted somewhere.
Okay. No. I said at the beginning we weren't going to solve this, but hopefully we're going to have a serious and thoughtful conversation. I really appreciate all of y'all doing that. That's what we need. We need more conversation, not less. We need to be able to talk about these things and hear each other and not jump up and say, you said something wrong, I'm going to cancel you, I'm going to get all over you. No, instead, we had an intelligent conversation and we kept the conversation going, and I hope we can have some more conversation, because this is important. It matters. Do you have a story or a question for me? Click the link in the description and tell me what in the world is going on.